What's up everyone, Jonas Lendwer hier, back with another edition of Source Comparison for Thomann Synthesizers. So, today we will have a closer look at not one, not two, but actually three different clone versions of the legendary SH-101 by Roland. So, without further ado, let's jump right in and let's find out which model you could make the most use of. At first, let's check out the boutique version by Roland itself. A small yet very powerful synthesizer to me. And I think this is the perfect version for everyone who has a smaller studio setup and want to go for this classic 101 sound. The standard version is coming without an attached keyboard, so let's find out if this has any disadvantages to the creative flow. The SH-01A has the same layout with its VCO, source mixer, VCF, VCA and envelope as the original 101, of course in a more compact version. You are able to take this device outside and play it by itself because you can put batteries inside. If you do so, you can actually use the ribbon knob to play keys. And then you can record them and sequence them. For the waveforms, we have the square wave, which sounds really great, the saw, and a sub. And the sub you can take down one or two octaves. But for now, let's sequence it with Ableton in the mono mode, because the SH-01A is actually able to play different modes. So simply go to the menu, 3 and assign it to mono. So let's check it out. And play with the envelope a little bit. And let's add some reverb to it. And a bit of portamento. So as said, you can choose different modes in the SH-01A, and besides the mono mode, you can choose unison, poly and chord mode, and poly and chord was not included in the original 101. So let's check out maybe the poly mode, why not? Assign poly. So there we go. So I like this device very much. It's a bit more compact, but fits in every smaller studio setup. And the sound of it is really great, crystal clear in the highs and punchy in the low ends. All right, next up, we have the biggest of all three versions, the Behringer MS-1. And I think it's very interesting that the biggest version is actually the cheapest and the smallest version, the Atlantis, is actually the most expensive. So let's find out if this means that this device has less to offer. The Behringer MS-1 came out in the end of 2019, and what it makes it different to the other two is actually its piano scale. All features are the same as in the original SH-101 with its VCF, VCA, modulation and the VCO. But Behringer added a triangle waveform to it actually. So the sound is the same as they proudly use the 3340 sound chip. Moreover, you can get it in three different colors, I think blue, metallic blue, red and gray. So let's check it out. If you are someone who likes to write melodies, bass lines and tracks, whatever, with the keys, I think this is the perfect option for you. Here we have the square, saw, triangle and the sub-oscillator also transposable to different octaves. So I like to mix it actually a little bit. Yeah, here maybe. So let's check it out a little bit. So what we can do now is fill in a sequence, because here is a step sequencer, and there it doesn't matter how you play it, it's just about what you play, because you fill in each step. So let's go into the first bank and first pattern. So make sure there is nothing in, erase that pattern. So and now we can record it. No, okay. Maybe a rest here. Rest again. Yeah, maybe here. All right, let's check out what we recorded. Maybe let's add some reverb to it. While you play it, you can actually transpose it by pressing keys. So let's check out the last version of today, the Atlantis by Intellijer. Intellijer is maybe one of my most favorite brands when it comes to Eurorack, so let's find out what this device has to offer for us. Here we have the Atlantis by Intellijer, the 101 inspired Eurorack module. But of course, with only this module, we can't do really much, so we need to add on, of course, the case, a MIDI interface, to have some portamento, the slew limiter, maybe some reverb, and of course an output module. So everything together, this makes the Atlantis maybe the most expensive version of a 101. And to be honest, from this price, we could buy an original 101, but we have more opportunities in this version. The Atlantis is of course a bit different looking than the both versions before, because it's in the Eurorack format. But basically you will find the same features as the other ones. Here is the source mix section. Well, the envelope is looking as the other ones, but in addition, Intellijer added their cycle mode, and you can multiply it by 10, as well as have some drive settings. In the VCF, you will find the choice in between a negative and positive polarity, as well as a low pass boost, and the choice in between 2 or 4 poles. So if you choose 2, then you have more overtones than in 4. So what makes the Atlantis special? Of course, the big difference here to the other versions are the patch points. And in total, you have 27 of them. With that, you are able to break the system up the way you want. So you can take different things in from other modules, you can send them to others as well, you can modulate the modulation, you can set different triggers to different things. All in all those features are too much to cover it up now in this video, but I will show some I like the most. So let's check out how it sounds first. Here is the square, saw, and the sub I like a lot. So what we can do now is use the LFO as second oscillator, and then we have a kind of duophonic module. So we could actually send a different sequence to the volt per octave, or we can just tune the oscillator to a different key to have something like coils going on. So all we have to do now is send the saw wave to the external in and then push it in the mix. Let's take the reverb. So, moreover, the last days I really enjoyed writing bass lines with the Atlantis because its low end is performing really outstanding. So, for this, let's switch the VCO again into the regular LFO mode. So, let's play it. And now I want to sync the LFO to the VCO and the envelope. So let's go, let's take our CV into our volt per octave and the gate to our, maybe this is a bit short, the gate to our sync to have a bit wobble with the key. So let's change this to our maybe a sign. There we go. You can actually hear the switch with the trigger and the key going faster and slower. All right, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and that I could deliver a small overview about the three versions of the SH-101. So let us know which version you prefer and see you next time. Thanks for watching.